Hey guys, this is Erica Sabo. Thank you so much for joining me. I feel like it has been a crazy long week and I needed this. I needed time to do a new video to just talk to you guys about the latest cool things that I've been raving about that I think you should be raving about too. So today I'm going to be talking about two Kickstarter projects I'm very excited about and I think you should be very excited about too, and maybe even fund. Only one of them is still on, the other's over, but I'm sure you can still fund those too. Regardless, the games in question are Dreamfall Chapters and Torment, Tides of Numenera. So let's start with Dreamfall Chapters. Dreamfall Chapters is the sequel to The Longest Journey and Dreamfall, The Longest Journey. These games were probably some of the best examples in the adventure point-and-click genre, particularly. Well, I don't know. That's kind of debatable. The Longest Journey is much more of a point-and-click experience, whereas I felt like The Longest Journey was much more, Dreamfall The Longest Journey, was much more of a dynamic experience. So the first one came out in 1999, very long time ago now, and the second one came out in 2006. So Red Thread Games, who developed both of these games, they decided to develop them independently and get their funding straight through Kickstarter, which I think is an amazing, amazing idea, considering then they have full control over the story, the characters, and the exact direction they want to go into with this. So unfortunately, that Kickstarter is already over, but it really blew my mind in the sense that they went above and beyond their goal. I think it was either 850,000 or 900,000. I can't remember off the top of my head, but they finished off just over 1.5 million. And this was maybe a week after launch. They had already exceeded their goal, which is really cool. Another thing I would like to thank Red Thread Games for is the fact that they were offering daily updates all throughout this campaign. They always had new things to tell you, they had new videos to show you. They were just so inviting in expressing and kind of showing their own world and what they plan on doing with this. So I'm very, very, very excited for this game. It's supposed to be coming out on PC, Mac, and Linux late 2014. Seems like a really long time, but the fact that they have this kind of power and that they can work on this game to this degree, at this girth, like, I'm really looking forward to this. And if you're adventure game fan, if you're a Longest Journey fan, there's no reason why you shouldn't be excited about this one too. So the one thing that they didn't reach that I really wish they had, although they talked about taking payments after the fact, is they did a lot of stretch goals, and their stretch goals were really cool in that they were going to add more content, they were going to add just more information about the mythos within the game, but the one that they wanted to reach with a $2 million goal was the end of April Ryan's journey, which is The Longest Journey Home. So that's going to be more of a traditional point-and-click game, but that I'm really looking forward to, and I know it's going to happen. I mean, they could easily start a new Kickstarter if they wanted to. My kitty is distracting me right now. She's a sweetie. You're so funny. Okay, back to this. yeah, so, you know, the Kickstarter is now over, but I think that they're still taking funding. Who knows, maybe they will start a new Kickstarter for The Longest Journey Home. Smaller scale game, but still something we've been waiting for since 1999. Come on, guys. So that's that. I'm linking to it right now for you, so you can check it out and you can contact the team if you want to share your thoughts, or if you just want to check out all the awesome things the game is going to have to offer. I hope you love it just as much as I do. So the next project I want to tell you about is Tides of Numenera. Now, as we speak, it's at 2.6 to 2.7 million, smack dab in the middle of there, and it is ridiculous. I don't even know what to say. The goal was actually 900,000, and there's still 20 days left in, well, as we speak, there are 20 days left in the campaign. That is ridiculous. So this one is being independently developed by In Exile, and it's not necessarily a continuation of Planescape Torment, which has always been known to be one of the best PC RPGs ever. Like, when it came out in 1999, it was heralded so, but even now, it's still considered one of the best because of its narrative, because of its philosophies, the environment it's set. Maybe not one of the most accessible games. Maybe it felt really slow. Maybe it just felt different, just not kosher like other RPGs you had seen at the time. But it definitely did some very different things that you didn't see in a lot of games in the genre. So this game looks amazing, and I'm so happy to see it's already been funded. So let me tell you a little bit about the story and how this story has already enticed me so much. You are the last cast off, the final link in the chain of the lives of the being they call the Changing God. He once was a man who discovered a way to use the relics of the ancients to cheat death and skip across the face of centuries and succession of bodies. But he never knew that his bodies lived on as his consciousness fled, a new consciousness arising in each. Now he has awakened an age-old enemy, the Angel of Entropy, and his days of change are gone as the angel hunts him and all his works. That includes you. With the ever-present threat of oblivion looming over you, you must find your sire before he and you are eradicated by the avenging angel. You will find allies and enemies among the other cast-offs. You might inhabit their minds for a time through the devices called the mirrors, turning their lives to your advantage. You will travel across the face of the ninth world, and above and below it, with your companions at your side, or alone, if you wish. Your quest will take you to alternate dimensions and distant worlds under strange suns. Particular mirrors might afford you even more bizarre experiences, such as folding time itself. And you will build your legacy as you find your answer to the question, what does one life matter? Now, I think that story right there really captures Planescape. I was so psyched because it's so unlike any RPG that, I'd played. And it's, wow, it's really cool. So, considering there's only concept art available right now, and the amount of loyalty all these people have for this game that won't even be released until the end of 2014 as well. It's amazing. It's so inspiring to see something like this. So I hope you enjoy this game as much as I'm sure I will. And if you want to play Planescape Torment, you can get it on GOG.com, which I will also link to. And I'll also link you to this Kickstarter. And speaking of which, I'll link you on GOG to The Longest Journey. I don't know where you can find Dreamfall, but I will link to that as well. So I really hope you enjoyed, guys, and I hope you stick around for my next video whenever that's gonna happen, which is pretty soon, I'm sure. So if you want, you please like and subscribe, and I hope you stick around. Cool, thanks guys, peace.